Demolition continues at the ORNL Low Intensity Test Reactor, Building 3005. Crews have completed teardown on the west side of the building, including the west laboratory and two water tank structures on the north side. Crews also completed tearing down the east laboratory and are now clearing the debris field.
Well, we're doing, I'll call it surgical demo on 3005 low intensity test reactor. The goal is to remove all of the ancillary facilities from around the main tower of 3005 to allow us then to remove some precast concrete slabs that are on the second floor by failing the shield block on the first floor. What we'll see is we'll be doing demo in phases. So this first phase is removing, we've already removed the west laboratory, the north ancillary facilities, that was a seal tank and a filter house building. Once we get those ancillary facilities removed, then we'll proceed with stripping the siding off of the high bay and exposing the structural steel to allow us to remove the structural steel above the third floor. So that's the next phase of demo.
The goal of this particular project was to clean the area of this creek bank where the ditch itself had drained into Poplar Creek during operation of the facility. We looked at a couple different ways to do it. One of the easiest ways would have been to dig down the side of the hill to it. That would have required moving about 8,000 cubic yards of clean soil out of the way. That's a big disturbance and a lot of restoration. So in looking at other methods that we could use, we decided to go with a barge-based approach. The UCOR piece of this was everything around the Sevenson work. Sevenson provided the barge and the equipment. The personnel who are used to working on the barge, they actually did the physical removal and packaging of the soils and the restoration of the areas. UCOR did the engineering, the planning, the construction of the barge launch where we're standing right now. In preparation for the work and then supported disposition of the waste containers that were generated during the excavation and helped demobilize and mobilize all the equipment on the site.
And so as we were looking through how we wanted to go execute this, we quickly realized that Sevenson brought a lot to the table. We keep hearing from DOE EM leadership that they would like to see new businesses and organizations come into our industry to bring value and different methods and means of doing things. And this is a prime example of where UCOR, through our parent company, reached out to an industry leader, Sevenson, to bring a new tool into our toolbox that was used for this cleanup and will be used for future task orders.
Crews have completed dismantling and packaging a HEPA filter unit that was previously removed from the roof of ORNL's building 3038, the Isotope Development Laboratory. The unit had been placed inside the building to reduce risk of contamination spread during weather events. It was originally placed in service in 1984 and served as filtration for multiple glove boxes, laboratory hoods, and the hot lab hot cell unit being deactivated in 2004. The housing and internal filters were considered highly contaminated, so the unit was carefully secured on a pallet and placed inside the shipping bay for characterization sampling. The packaged unit was placed in a 20-foot metal container and will be shipped to Nevada for safe disposal. UCOR is performing an inspection of the 70-year-old 250-foot 3039 stack that is still in use at ORNL. The inspection will determine the stack's remaining lifespan and what repairs are needed.
So what we're doing is we're performing a stack inspection. We got a 70-year-old stack, got some degradation, and we're just trying to do an inspection to see what the status is and figure out what the lifespan of the stack is and figure out what repairs are going to be required to keep it operational in the future. We're no longer able to use the step irons that were originally installed, and we're actually installing a new ladder on the stack and inspecting as we go up.
While EM has used drones to perform visual inspections over the years, this will be the first physical inspection since 1995. Current schedules have the structure standing another 10 years before it's taken down, underscoring the importance of making needed repairs. A 3M Safety Roadshow was held for nuclear operations personnel, with approximately 90 people attending classes on fall protection, hearing protection, and eye injuries. The hands-on training was provided free of charge. SNH programs have worked closely with the Nuclear Operations Group to take advantage of this unique training opportunity.
We're here with the 3M Roadshow. It's a thing that we're happy to have here at UCOR. It is a nationwide event, national event. They go around to several key projects throughout the United States and show us new and innovative tools and equipment that we can use that make our job safer and better, which is always a focus here at UCOR. We're thankful for scientific sales working with 3M to help us put this on, and it's been a fantastic addition to our safety program here at UCOR.
The first fully electric vehicle in the EM complex has arrived at UCOR. UCOR is slated to receive 11 EVs as the first phase of EM's effort to increase electric vehicles across the DOE complex. These vehicles will be delivered as they become available through the U.S. General Services Administration and will steadily replace the existing inventory. Transitioning the fleet is estimated to avoid up to 320 metric tons in annual carbon emissions and $50,000 in fuel costs annually based on the national average cost of gas and electricity. The opportunities for improvement aren't stopping with fleet vehicles. ORNL, in partnership with UCOR, is pursuing a transition to low-speed electric vehicles and zero-emissions heavy equipment for its environmental remediation mission as those vehicles become commercially available. Stay tuned to see the progress we make next month and follow us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter.